Hey guys, my name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. We're looking at another new pedal from the good people at Orange, and this is the Fur Coat Fuzz, and subtle it is not. It is a wall of sonic mayhem, as I'm sure you can hear from the intro, with both regular and octave variations on this big, thick 70s-inspired fuzz sound. Now this pedal is based on the literally fur-coated Fox tone machine from the 1970s, which was it's a really sought-after vintage fuzz that was literally covered in a furry carpet, and that's where the term fur coat comes from, I can presume. But the notes have a very kind of furry quality about it, so there's kind of a dual meaning going on there. Let's talk about the features, and then we'll listen to some more tones. So, turning over to the pedal itself, it's a pretty simple affair. You'll see we have two foot switches, one for fuzz and one for octave. The fuzz needs to be on for the octave to be active, but you'll notice when you switch the octave on, the LED turns from blue to this wonderful shade of 1970s purple. We've got this little bar here to stop you from kicking your settings in a moment of fuzz-induced rage. And we have four controls. We've got one for fuzz, which of course I've left on full because that's how we like it. I have a volume control, which I can use to either boost an already dirty amp or I can use to match with my clean sound. We have an EQ control, which is kind of there for kind of blending your sound to suit the sonic signature of the amplifier that you're using. For what we're doing today, it works really well at 12 o'clock, but we'll have a play with that in a moment. And this is really cool. This is the octave control, which allows you to dial in either just a little bit or a whole lot of octave into your fuzz. Now let's start off by exploring the sounds of the fuzz minus octave. First of all though, here's the clean sound we're using today. It's an Orange TH30 head, and everything is at 12 o'clock. Sounds like this. Okay, so engaging the fuzz, let's set this fuzz control at about 12 o'clock, so it's about halfway up, and we'll listen to how it sounds. We get this kind of noise. Then rolling things back, we do get a little more subtlety as we go back to the 9 o'clock mark. It's still pretty intense though, sounds like this. So even at these lower ranges, the fuzz is still very, very, very fierce, buzzy. It's just, again, it is just a wall of beautiful, glorious, disastrous noise. Now, let's experiment with the EQ control. I'm gonna turn things back up to about 12 o'clock. We'll hear how it sounds. I'm just gonna chug on some open power chords. So as we've turned it up, you can hear things get very bright and barky. Let's bring it back, see what happens. And here we have a very woolly, very rich, low-end, thick delivery. Really, really cool. You can use this to marry with lots of different amps. If you have a very bright sounding amp, you might try the lower positions. Conversely, if you're playing into quite a compressed sounding amp, you'll try the higher ones. Pretty self-explanatory. There is a lot of volume on tap, but we're not gonna play with that too much. We're gonna leave it pretty much where it is. Let's have a listen to the octave. And once again, we'll leave everything at its 12 o'clock position. Let's start by engaging the octave. You'll notice this red LED comes on alongside the blue to create this cool purple kind of color, which is really nice. Lets you know the octave is on. Once again, the fuzz needs to be active for the octave to operate. It'll do nothing if the fuzz is not on, so it's not gonna work just as an octave pedal on its own. Let's start with the octave on zero. Again, I'll chug on some open chords and we'll see what happens. you can hear, as we turn that up, we go from basically the fuzz with just the tiniest hint of octave to an almost entirely octave shifted signal. It can be very subtle, it can be very, very drastic, and you can dial this depending upon your application. Let's try some octave shifted lead work with everything turned all the way up. Should be reasonably reminiscent of a certain Mr. James Marshall Hendrix. Let's have a listen. Here we go. And you can hear some really cool oscillation happening there on the long delays. Let's bring the octave back to somewhere around the 10, 11 o'clock region. Let's try some riffing with this setting and we'll see how that sounds. So as you can hear, you can dial in a much more subtle octave effect that's not going to dominate the sound like a lot of octave fuzz pedals can. So it's really quite flexible in that regard, despite the fact that you're only able to dial up the most destructive of fuzz tones with this pedal. Now, that is the sound of the pedal into a clean amp. Let's try it into the sound of a dirty amp, and I'm going to flip over to the dirty channel on our Orange TH30. Let's see how that sounds. Okay, so we've moved over to our dirty channel on its own. It sounds like this. Not a huge amount of gain going on, but kind of that nice classic rock crunch. Let's engage the fuzz and see what happens. So when you have a distorted amp, things start to take on an altogether kind of more compressed and hunkered down kind of sound. You can hear as I move through these single note lines, there's this kind of really cool oscillation that sort of moves along the top of the sound, and it seems to descend with my lines. And if I hold a long sustained note, the oscillation seems to move and come to life depending upon the envelope of what I'm putting in. Very, very cool stuff. Let's try it with a little bit of octave. Nudge that on, sounds like this. So with the octave engaged, even at this relatively conservative setting of 12 o'clock, you can see we get this really cool, chaotic, almost synth-like kind of sound. It's a really fun and inspiring pedal. It's quite versatile in fairness, given the simple control layout, depending upon the amp that you run it into. And again, depending on the guitar that you use, the position of your tone control, you can really dial up a whole load of interesting sounds with this. It's very, very cool. Certainly not for the faint of heart, but if you're into your fuzz odysseys, this might be the thing for you. I've had a whole lot of fun playing this one, but then again, I like my fuzz an awful lot. So I'm gonna leave that there. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. This has been the Fur Coat Fuzz from Orange, and I'll catch you next time.